Change Talkback Radio Show. Join in on informational, motivational, and controversial topics. It's all about the exchange. Here's your host, your girl Stormy on the mic, and co-host Eddie Up. All the
way up. What's up? What's up, people? Ah, we did it again. Hey,
did,
DJ.
Did he do the er?
I didn't hear the er.
Because you came in before he did it.
Did I? I came in too fast, you know. Excited. I got to get my cues, okay? Good evening. We don't have the rights to this music, but we are ASCAP holders, meaning that we have purchased the rights to be able to play this music, so don't take us down. Compton Exchange Talk Radio is our urban connection. And I'm your host, Stormy on the mic, and this is my homeboy.
Eddie, yep.
How you guys doing this evening? I want to give a shout-out to everybody that's been calling and supporting us. It's been truly a blessing for us.
Yeah.
I got a lot of calls last week with people just wanting to support and make donations, and so you know who you are. So I just want to say thank you for that, because that's just that just keeps us motivated to keep on going, right, Eddie?
That's right. That's right.
So that's that. We need all that motivation.
Yeah.
So, Eddie, what's happening with our show?
Well, you know, our show is inspirational, informative, and controversial. We will bring to you every Thursday at 6:30 to 8. A show that we feel represents our community. And our first guest tonight is...
Jane Zarita?
Jane Zarita.
I thought I was going to do Wakanda.
Well, we're going to do Wakanda.
Okay, check it out. Y'all going to have to go and see Black Panther.
Yeah.
Because that is bomb. Did y'all see my dots? Y'all see? I'm trying to represent. Got my dice shiki on. Eddie wouldn't let me put any dots on his face, but so he ain't in, you know. he not with the program today.
I am not for that tonight.
But we are here today, and what we want to do is Black History Month, and we want to play homage to Dolores Zarita. Now, everybody should know Dolores Zarita. I mean, this is a beautiful sister. This is a beautiful woman. I mean, she has so much history, and she's been holding Compton down for a long, long time. You know, and we are just grateful to have her daughter here to represent for her, Jaina Zarita. Come on over, Jaina.
Yeah, her mother was a catalyst, man. She helped us out a lot when we was Dickinson Dolls too.
Yeah,
she's been around for a while, and she's a milestone to count, a headstone. What you call it? Milestone.
Yeah, go ahead and put that on. Yeah, so you can hear. They want us to pull
beautiful
this back.
Beautiful lady, and still the same, ain't changed.
Oh yeah, she's a pioneer.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, they want you to come closer to me, girl. They want to get you
looking like your mama.
The older I get,
right?
Is she good? Are we good? Can you see her good?
A little bit more.
Pull it in.
How's that? The better? Is she going in motion? She's going against the wall.
They want you to lean in. Okay, girl, because we got to get everybody in here. Well, you know, this is Councilwoman Jaina Zarita, and I'm just laughing at myself saying that she's represents the first district, because you know she's a little under me. So, you know, we used to run and play dodgeball or something together. You know what I'm saying? So now I'm sitting next to her and she's a councilwoman. How about that?
Huh. You know, how about that? And Eddie, too. You know, we all kind of grew up together.
Yes.
Yeah, buddy.
And can remember some of the great things in the city of Compton and remember the heroes. A lot of we three had some of the same heroes in the city of Compton. And I'm truly honored to be here tonight to represent my mother, Dolores Zarita. Who is truly a hero in the city of Compton.
Yes, she is.
And in our lives, in my life.
Yes.
She couldn't be here tonight. She had a knee surgery, a knee replacement, just recovering. She had it Monday. She's doing great.
Praise God.
She loves to tell her age. She's 81.
All right.
Good.
Yeah.
Still look good, too.
She do. You know,
she is a good looking 81.
We got a long way to go. We got to do something to keep up with that.
Right.
But she, Dolores Zarita, she came here to the city of Compton in 1949 with her family. She married her husband at 17. They're still married. They've been married 64 years. My
How
father,
about
Clarence Zarita. Hey, that deserves an award.
Girl, look, clap. We got to clap on that. We need to clap on that, honey, because, look, I couldn't make it past 10 years. But anyway,
you
go ahead with 64, baby. Look.
Yeah, you know.
Two-time loser. Go, girl. What?
Hey, but look what you waited for, huh?
Hey, girl, look. Yeah. Go ahead with that. Look, I guess maybe I might get about 30 out of it, right?
Yeah, possibility.
So, you know, I don't know really. I guess I'll start from the beginning with my mother. She started in 1969. She funded her nonprofit, which was Dickerson Community Lighted Schools.
Okay.
And she actually started the first after school program. They used to call it Latchkey Kids.
Okay.
And it was at Dickerson Elementary School, and everybody from the community, from good to bad, the gangsters, mm-hmm. the gangbangers or whatever you want to call them, they came to that after school program and truly became a part of the community. And they still respect and remember my mother to this day.
We all do.
Yeah. It's freezing outside, too.
Sure is.
I should not went to that little thing out there because now I'm feeling a little stuffy. But so Dolores, and she had two partners with her. That was Miss Filer.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And you guys remember Miss
Russo? Of course. Yes.
Ms.
Regina Russo's Russo, mother.
Regina
Russo's
mother. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The Russo's and the Filers and the Zaritas.
And the Zaritas.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. And so they worked together in the after school program. You remember we was in the drill team.
Of course. Dickerson
and
Dolls, baby.
And the band.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right.
We used to have fun.
We did.
Yeah,
Dickerson
we did.
Spell it.
Yeah, because you know Miss Filer made our outfits.
Yes, she did.
All the fringes.
Yes. Always had mine a little too small.
Yeah. Always. Yeah, you know, Eddie had that jumpsuit on.
Had that jumpsuit on it way up here. I was flooding.
Yes,
but
sure.
we did our thing, though.
We did our thing.
Our turtleneck.
And then Dolores, with the after-school program, first, I guess she was the first PTA president at Dickerson Elementary School. And it was funny because our mothers are like, mm-hmm. you know, when we went to elementary school, mm-hmm. they followed us right mm-hmm. over there to mm-hmm. elementary.
And yes, they did.
They went to Davis with us. But she, after, once the funding stopped for the after school program, she transitioned over to the senior nutrition program,
okay.
which she delivered to about, she did, delivered over 3 million meals in the city of Compton to shut-in senior citizens that were unable to get a balanced meal. Probably everybody, she's fed everybody's mother, our grandmother, mm-hmm. in the city of Compton. And so with that program, that went on for about 40 years, and she just retired from that in 2012.
Mm.
But during,
how about that?
Huh, during that program, she was elected, overwhelmingly elected to the Compton City Council.
I'm sure.
Where she served in the first district of the city of Compton.
Now, you served in the first district as
mm-hmm.
well, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so you just following your mother's footsteps?
Absolutely.
I ain't mad,
know,
girl.
And
do that. Yes.
And you and your sisters.
Right.
Yeah, my sister's on the school board. So, and it's really a trip because
the dynamic duo.
I sit in the same seat that my mother sat in, and I have the same office that she had in City Hall. And when she retired from the Dickerson Mills on Wheels, I took that furniture that she had and took it over to the City Hall office.
Mm.
So, you know, and you know, my mother, really, I wish she could have been here tonight.
I wish she could have been here as
well.
She
can't tell her story better than anybody
yeah,
else.
Yeah.
And, you know, my mother was on the city council. She was indicted. She was taken to jail.
What?
Yeah, you didn't know that? Mm-hmm.
You know, I heard something about it, but you know, you don't really think about it. You know what I'm saying? She was indicted and taken to jail. Now, Father God, that's a whole lot, baby, because I sat in jail for like 5 minutes and almost lost my mind. So I can't imagine being indicted and going to jail.
Well, she didn't stay long. You know, we got her bailed out
right
away. But she did have a 3-month trial. But I tell you, you know, folks, they think some things are a joke, but that's been about, I think that was in 2002. Yeah, when she got indicted. And
why was she indicted?
She was accused. Well, the city treasurer,
Doug Sanders
lied mm-hmm. on my mother. He actually lied on my mother. He provided false evidence to the DA. And you know, the one thing that
we're talking about money.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like and so after the trial, they owed my mother money, the city of Compton.
How about that?
You know? So, What I did learn from sitting with my mother through a 3-month trial is, you know, you're supposably innocent until proven guilty, but
yeah.
once you charge with something, you got to prove
you
that prove
you
didn't
you,
do it.
You didn't do
oh,
it,
that's
yeah.
true. That,
yeah.
That's how the system works. I mean, we know that's truly how the system works, and people looking at you totally different. Those that had your back no longer have
your back
because they've already judged. I mean, they have.
They're judgmental already.
Right. That's the get-go. That's
minute,
the way
you
they
know,
do.
It's like once you get indicted, Joe, you got to pick up your phone sometimes and say, wow, does my
phone
work?
Yeah, because nobody else calls. Yeah, you know? Let's stay away from them. You know what I'm saying? Because they're already accusing you.
Yeah, so my mother was indicted, and actually she told me when I ran for council, because you know I wouldn't and never was and will not ever be politically correct, but But my mother told me, she told me one day, she said, about 8 years later, she said, guess who's going to run for council? And I said, who? And she said, you. And I'm like, oh, Lord, let me get myself together. You know?
I was shocked at that.
But, you know, but I had to do it for my mother, you know, because, okay. you know, my mother left out in a bad way. And my mother served Dolores Zurita, like mm-hmm. y'all call her, Ms. Zurita. Mm-hmm. She served the community for 60 years, you know, so I think she deserved to have her name restored.
Of course yeah, she does. I mean, yeah. and she was found innocent.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
Okay, so, you know.
That's the cold part.
God, no, God is a good God. At the end of the day,
after a 3 month trial.
Yeah, after a 3 month trial, yeah, she was found innocent. But, you know, sometimes we got to go through the storm, you know. And so she went through the storm. But okay, look what it's produced.
Oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm.
Okay, I mean, looks what it's produced. And she's a strong sister.
Yeah, so Dolores Zurita, she brought back $1 million of funds here to do a study on senior citizens, the mm-hmm. elderly, on having 3 balanced meals 7 days a week, how it will lengthen their lives. And today, that model, that study is still a model for senior programs, the senior daycare centers. What she did was they provided 3 meals a day. When they took that one meal, they would take meals for the weekend and they would take a dinner. And the folks actually, all of their vital signs, blood pressure, mm-hmm. diabetes, mm-hmm. everything kind of made some corrections after, you know, having those 3 balanced meals. And Dolores was, she was one of 6 children, and she always said she was her mother's lucky child.
Okay.
And, you know, I truly believe that. My mother, Dolores, is truly an angel. And what's one of the great things about Dolores is that she can talk to anybody.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
She can talk to the man pushing a basket or, you know, sometimes mm-hmm. she used to go to the store to get some eggs, and she come back like, Mom, what took you so long? You know, you've been gone 2 hours to get some eggs. Oh, well, I had to talk to, you know, this person and that person, and, okay. you know, people she don't even know. But Dolores was a humanitarian.
Okay.
I mean, she has been honored by so many people, by the senators, congresswomen, congressmen, and she... What's something you remember about Dolores?
You know what? I just remember. You know what?
I get myself together.
No, you go ahead and get yourself together. I just remember, like, you know, my mother, your mother, I mean, they were true troopers as far as us being at school. You know, they was right there. I mean, it's a different type of school situation nowadays as kids is going to school. But I just remember my mom and a lot of the moms, including your mom, were always at the school. They were very active in the school. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So mm-hmm. I just remember your mother as always being very active. And it's apparent that she continued with that as far as even going into this being in a council person, you know, and doing all the different programs that she's done and being honored the way she has been honored. And she's been here and she's still here. Okay.
Oh,
a lot of people are not still living in Compton. You know, my mom doesn't live in Compton. She's actually in Moreno Valley, you know, but your mom is still here, you know, and she's still working in the community and she's pushing her daughter. She done put this, the dynamic duo together, you know, mm-hmm. so, the, you know, Team Zurita, you know, y'all ain't playing out here. And so her legacy lives on through you all, you know, so she's still doing her thing as far as I'm concerned, you know, and I just love your mother. And it was just, I mean, it would just be who was not to actually honor her, you know, as this being Black History Month. We have to honor Dolores Zurita.
Well, you know, and just to say, and I'm looking at some of my mother's awards. I didn't know she, in 1995, I didn't remember she was Woman of Color, Breast Cancer Survivor, Activist of the Year. She doesn't have breast cancer, but she just works for, you know.
Okay.
She's an activist for everything. But she was 2012 Delta Sigma Theta, Compton Alumni Chapter, Woman of the Year. Senator Rod Wright, Woman of Dedicated Award, 52nd Assembly District, Isidore Hall, Woman of the Year. I mean, and the list just goes on and on and on and on.
You have some platforms, and we want to show these because we're running out of time, but we want to show some things that were back in the day. So I'm going to walk over there. Well, Eddie can get it. You know, let the man do it, child. That's what they say.
Ha.
Mm-hmm. Let him get up and pick it up.
You know. Either one. Those were.
I remember she told my father.
What she tell your father?
She told me. She said,
"Let me see.
You know, your daddy work in the school district."
Well, we don't know if you guys can see this, but we wanted to show it. And this looks like it says Clarence A. Dickerson, the PTA organization meetings. And so it has Ms. Zurita here, and she's right here.
Right there.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful, beautiful. Always involved. Mm-hmm. Always involved. So that's a blessing. You guys remember her?
Ms. Robinson.
Ms. Robinson, Ms. Robinson, the principal. Principal. Exactly. Mm-hmm. This is amazing. Let's see that one, Eddie.
And Ms. Filer is right there, too.
Where's Ms. Filer?
Ms. Filer. Oh, Ms. second Filer. From the end. Right there.
Right here.
Okay. All right. All right, Ms. Filer.
Yeah, so to keep it real, those were some of the exhibits that we used in my mother's trial.
Oh, okay.
Exhibit A.
This is okay. And here's exhibit B. Alrighty then.
Exactly. She could have did this.
Do you see her? You know she's innocent. Look.
You know, just to show some of the things that how early on she got involved in the community.
All right.
And pretty much Dolores dedicated her whole life to serving the community.
Look, and you know, one thing about that is obviously she didn't need the money. She was a housewife, baby. She stayed up at the school. So somebody was taking care of home. So they need to knock it off.
Huh. Yeah. My daddy.
Your daddy. Yeah. That's right. He was holding it down, so she didn't need no change. She was changed up already. She had a change.
Yeah, and my daddy had a hustle, too.
You know, all right. So. Well, we ain't mad at that.
Well, my daddy was the Compton head custodian for all the Compton schools.
Okay.
Well, you know, my daddy retired from L.A. Water and Power.
Power, yeah.
Uh-huh. And, you know, back then, you know, 60 years ago, that was a good job.
Okay.
Yes, it is.
Yeah,
it
good
is.
Job for a black man.
Passes that right there.
And
now, you guys, you know we're running out of time, so we want to go ahead and we want to give this to you. It's a certificate of appreciation. This certificate is awarded to Dolores Zarita in recognition of valuable contributions. And you guys, you know, we knew the exchange is new, but you know, we pay homage to our people. We know where we come from, okay? Uh-huh. And so this is the first person, Dolores Zarita, that we've actually paid homage to. And it's just been a privilege and a pleasure to have you come on and represent for your mother. And tell her
we love her.
She probably watching.
Hey.
She loves social
Miss
media.
Ms. Zarita.
And yes. You know, and with all the awards that she do have, but to be awarded by YouTube,
people that she had dealt with when we was little.
Absolutely, this will be very special and dear to her heart. And I want to thank you guys so much.
And tell her we love her.
Remembering my mother.
Oh,
thank
yeah,
you,
definitely.
Thank you. Okay, we'll be back in 5 with our next guest. Thank you so much for coming, Jaina.
Thank you,
Miss Arita.
Talk Back Radio Show. Join in on informational, motivational, and controversial topics. It's all about the exchange. Here's your host, your girl Stormy on the mic, and co-host Eddie Up. All the way up. Join in on informational, motivational, and controversial topics. It's all about the exchange. Here's your host, your girl Stormy on the mic, and co-host Eddie Up. All the way up.
Don't hear anything.
Hello? Well, you know, that's what happens when you get to actually see what we're doing. You know, Eddie's over here knocking down coffee and stuff. I told him, you know, it's like when you tell your kids, you know, put it over here so it won't fall. But he was trying to be a gentleman and help
I
her.
I had it over here. I had to move it over here. Yeah, wouldn't be in his know, way. I'm forgot. Trying to save her life from being stabbed by her mite.
Yeah, but
and you know how she is.
Yeah, exactly.
You know I got it.
That's right. That's right. You done got all my stuff with coffee okay. on it, but it's all
they
good.
They can't see that.
Okay, well, anyway, we're going to do one of our sponsors. Okay, so this is like too far for me. Diamond Daycare. If you want to provide your child with daycare environment that feels like home, call Diamond Daycare. They are located in the beautiful city of Carson, California. They provide affordable daycare for ages infant to age 13. They're open Monday through Friday from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. They can be reached at 310-600-7802. Again, that number is 310-600-7802. And ask for Jewel. How did I do?
Okay. That was very professional.
Okay, well, all right now. Next week, we'll have it we're pre-recorded. We'll bring in our voiceover person and handle that. But until then, our sponsors are helping us out, so we're going to go ahead and still make sure we, you know,
we're doing our
give
thing.
They shout out. Okay, now, who do we have here?
We got Kathy and Michael Jones.
And
they are with...
Changing Lives.
They are changing lives. It's the heart-to-heart for you. She'll give us a little history on the nonprofit organization, and we're going to hand it over to
that
young
lady
over there, Kathy.
Hi, I'm doing good.
You good? You nervous?
Yes,
girl, don't be nervous. He done dropped coffee all over me, honey, so you can get past that. Don't even be nervous. We met actually last week.
Yes.
Okay. And the reason for our meeting is because we're both going to be actually Saturday out at the grocery outlet.
Yes.
Okay. Compton Grocery
Outlet. Compton Grocery Outlet. We're going to be streaming live, you guys, at Compton Grocery Outlet. They want you to be still. The director's saying, quit swinging the chair.
Sorry.
So we're both going to be live. We're going to be streaming live out at the Grocery Outlet. And Kathy and her husband from Heart to Heart are actually a nonprofit organization, and they're going to be there as well. So tell us a little bit about Heart to Heart.
Heart to Heart was birthed about 15 years ago because of my heart for children. And I know from being raised in the city of Compton that a lot of people don't have shoes. So we got together and out of my pocket, like Zarita said earlier, mm-hmm. out of my pocket, I was purchasing shoes and toys and giving them away to kids. And so
The less fortunate,
yes. So the shoes that we will be giving away on Saturday are actually for the less fortunate.
Oh, that's awesome. Mm. So you've been in business 15 years.
We've been in business 15 years, but we've only had our 501c3 since 2013.
Okay, God is a good guy. So God laid it on your heart to give.
Yes.
And now he's done blessed you with a nonprofit organization so that you can bless others.
Yes.
That's a blessing. That's a blessing. Now, who do we have here?
This is
Spike.
Spike?
Mike.
Oh, I thought he said Spike. I was like, girl, Spike is in the house. What happened? All right, Mike, how you doing, Mike?
Doing good. This mic on?
Can you hear?
Go ahead.
Yes.
Can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear.
Okay.
Yes.
So, how do you help Kathy out in the nonprofit organization?
Well, Heart to Heart is a grassroots organization, and it's a shoe ministry where we go out and go to the unprivileged children and wash their feet, pray with them, put a pair of shoes on their feet. And I'm basically is a right-hand man for us, setting up everything and doing all the heavy lifting.
Are you a pastor?
No, I'm not.
You just anointed, huh?
If you want me to be.
Okay, now you guys actually go out and take a basin and put people's feet in them and you wash them?
Yes.
That's biblical based.
Yes, biblical based.
And this is a biblical based organization.
Biblical based.
That's what I'm talking about. Praise God. You know what I'm saying? Going out here washing feet.
Now baptizing feet.
Right. Now that's serious.
Yes. And you'll be surprised when you wash the feet what the kids want you to pray for.
Is that
it's
right?
It's never about them. It's always about somebody in their family. Mm-hmm. You know.
That's great.
It's beautiful.
So how many people? So when you wash in feet, how many feet do you wash, you know, in one setting?
Anywhere from 200 to 400.
In one setting?
Yeah, we have volunteers, though, to do that. You have to have volunteers, at least 20 chairs set up.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And that's a beautiful thing. That's a beautiful thing. So all this came, this thing birthed out of just your kindness, you wanting to give back. Did you see a lot of despair when you were growing up?
Well, you know, growing up in the city of Compton, doing bad things, and then when you change your life, you want to give back to where you messed up. So that's what we wanted to do as a family. We said we wanted to give back to the city that we kind of destroyed. So that's what we do, anywhere we can and however we can.
So some right. Hard work. You said destroyed. You felt like you did some damage.
We did some damage. Our families did some damage to the city of Compton. We not gonna say what
right.
So we want to try to help make a change while we can.
Well, what a blessing! Thank God that God turned you around, right?
Yes.
Okay. That's amazing. Well, changing lives. Let's look at this. It says, Heart to Heart is focused on the needs of children, foster, military, underprivileged, homeless of all ages. We are a 501c3 nonprofit organization that reaches out to the communities. Heart to Heart is dedicated to take a life and changing message to hope to people and equipping the feet of impoverished children and adults with shoes. So this says do you give adults shoes as well?
Yes.
Okay, so this is not just about the children, this is about the adults as well.
It's about anybody that's in need.
Indeed.
Now, you know, that's a blessing. You know what I'm saying? Because you see, you know, it's so cold outside right now. It's so cold. And we're not even accustomed to it being this cold. And it's probably not really even cold. I'm just cold. But to see the homeless people on the streets, you know what I'm saying? And just to see people that are in need. So if a homeless person came, you would actually give them shoes as well?
Yes.
See, that's a blessing. That's something good to know that if a homeless person comes on Saturday and they want some shoes and you have, so what shoe sizes?
It goes all the way up to a size 12. And if we see a homeless person in the line, we bring them up front.
Okay.
So they have priority.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. That's amazing. So is there a limit? So if I'm a mother and I have five children, are you going to put shoes on all five of my children, or is it there's a limit when it comes to the family?
No. If you have 5, 10 children, mm-hmm. all 10 of your children will get a pair of shoes.
Okay. That's awesome.
And just say this here. Saturday, it's no feet washing Saturday.
No feet.
We don't have enough volunteers to wash feet, so don't come there with your feet ready to be washed. They're going to pray over you and give you the shoes, but we want no feet washing.
Okay.
And it's first come, first serve.
Okay. First come, first serve. Okay. So they have a limited amount of shoes. Okay, we're going to be at the grocery outlet in Compton over on Rosecrans.
Yes.
And Central.
Okay, and that time is going to be from 11 to 1. Okay, and so come out and support Heart to Heart.
Heart to Heart.
Come out and support Compton Exchange Talk Radio, because we're going to be out there going live, me and old Eddie.
Yep, and I'm going to be spilling coffee.
He's going to be spilling coffee, whether he's eating a donut or whatever else. It's going to be cold, child, so you will need this little coffee. But we have a call.
Okay, we can.
Hello, caller.
Great show.
Thank you. How are you?
Good.
Do you have any questions for Heart to Heart?
No, this is very interesting about the homeless, what they're doing for the homeless. I think it's very great.
Well, thank you, caller, for calling, and we appreciate that. I mean, that I'm sure that's blessing them as well.
That sounds like my mother.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
That sounds like my mother.
It's all right if it's your mother, honey. Yeah, another call. Like, yeah, okay, well, it probably wasn't watching. Your mother. That's it not was your mother. You know your mother's asleep anyway.
My mother woke.
Is your mother named Kathy?
Mm-hmm.
Is that Kathy? Is that you? No.
Yes, this is me.
No, we're talking about his mother. It probably was his mother. Because when we first start, you know, trying to get this thing together, you know, she'd be the first one to call. She'd be like, I'm trying to call. Look, I want to call. So we appreciate you, Kathy. We appreciate your support. We appreciate that you're looking out for us and calling in. So thank you for that. But do you have anything else you want to tell the people about your organization? Other than it's faith-based. Okay, you guys been doing this thing for like 15 years?
Yes.
It was birthed out of your heart?
Yes.
Okay, y'all came and tore up Compton, but now y'all ready to give it back?
Yes.
I ain't mad at you, girl. That's what's up. That's a blessing.
Yes.
It's a blessing that you're even able to do it.
Yes.
Okay, because some people walk away and just leave it like it is, right?
Yeah.
And it seems like you got a soul-tied husband right here with you, got your back. He said he's right there with you. You got a soldier walking with you. Girl, you got this thing.
Yes, yes.
So this is a blessed organization. And so we support you guys, and we can tell everybody, come out Saturday. Let's turn up at the grocery outlet.
Well, this will be our first time in District 1.
Okay.
We've been in all the districts in Compton. This will be our first time in District 1.
Okay, so that's Jana Zarita's district. The councilwoman just
left out of here.
We're going to be in her district.
She and this is their first time.
That she's going to try to come out and support. She has some, I think, a funeral or something that she might need to attend. But you got to see Councilwoman Jana Zarita, and she's very supportive. So it's a blessing that you're in her district, and I'm sure she will be getting in touch with you. If she doesn't get to see you, I'm sure she will, so that you guys can do this thing again. It is a blessing to have you on our station. We hope to bring you back so you can tell us about other great things that you're doing in the community so that we can broadcast it and let our people know.
Amen. All right. Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming, guys.
Yes. All right. We're going to take another break, and we'll be right back with, who are we going back with? The cleanup man.
The cleanup man.
If, the cleanup man.
Diggity dog.
Born and raised in Compton.
Talkback Radio Show. Join in on informational, motivational, and controversial topics. It's all about the exchange. Here's your host, your girl Stormy on the mic, and co-host Eddie Up. All the way
up. Right, here we go.
We're going to do another little commercial break here. And this is about the cookie jar. Mm. The cookie jar.
You know what? The cookie jar. That sounds about like our show last week. When they was talking about the cookie. Woo. You know, this is a grown folks show, okay? You guys be going. This is 7 o'clock hour, so we in that grown folks conversation. But you remember they were talking about the cookie jar, right? So go ahead and talk about the cookie jar, sponsor the cookie jar.
All right. The cookie jar specializes in custom homemade and unique specialty cookies. Baked to order. You choose your cookie dough and as many mixers as you like for your very own cookie creation. They also have a variety of specialty cookies that they create that you are welcome to try.
All right.
You can order online at thecookiejaronline.com.
All right. That's thecookiejaronline.com to order your wonderful, wonderful cookies.
Oh, those are good cookies.
Oh, my goodness. Now, we here. Okay, this show is called A Cleanup Man. Now, you know, you got wives, you got girlfriends, you got live-ins, you got all of that. Now, if your man ain't taking care of home, guess what? There's a cleanup man ready to take care of it for you. So I think all the little brothers need to be tuned in right now so they can get some knowledge. Because knowledge is key into keeping your home safe. Because if you don't, guess what? It's a lot of lonely wives and a lot of lonely girlfriends out there.
And who we with?
We here with, they call him Diggy Doc.
Mr. Diggy Doc.
And Diggy we can be Doc. Reached at area code 310-946-3110. And that again is
310-946-3110.
There you go. So, Diggy Doc.
You're welcome to call in.
Yes, ma'am.
It's a blessing to have you here, bro. How you doing?
I'm doing well. Thanks for having me.
Good to have you.
You know, it's hard to get people to come out here talking about, you know, they're the cleanup man. And so you ain't got no problem coming. So, you know, we jump right on that.
Oh, well, my name is what it is. It speaks for itself.
Oh, okay.
He's still cool.
So, he was cool when he was little. Look at you. Ooh, Father God. Where did you get the name Diggy Doc from? What does that mean?
Diggy Doc comes from actually having a prescription of doing what I need to do to make people feel good. The doc is short for doctor, so the doctor has a prescription, right?
Right.
So if you need to feel good, the Diggy Doc.
Last week, you know what? Last week, that's crazy that you said, because last week we, what the lady was last week?
What was the lady?
The lady, they called in, she was
she's a therapist.
Therapist.
We had a therapist, now we got a doctor. We had a therapist on the line to tell you what it took in order, because she was a side chick. Ooh, and she said she was a therapist.
Now we got a doctor in the house.
Oh my God. Okay. So what's the problem with these women and this outside help they seem to need?
Basically, they seeking help because they're not getting what they need at home.
Okay.
And what's that they're not getting at home far as, you know?
Well, as far as me being a doctor, is you have different cases. Each case is different. So, therefore, this one here might be missing this one. That one might be missing that. Mm-hmm. But what you do, you interview them, you find out what they're missing, and then you give them what they're missing.
You give them the prescription.
They get the prescription. You write them out the prescription and make it happen.
So how long do cleanup last?
It varies. Mm-hmm. It varies. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes they get caught up. The doctor's not playing with feelings or emotions. Mm-hmm. He's just playing. Mm-hmm. You know, women are emotional. They put emotions into it.
We have a call. We have a call. You ready to take calls, doctor?
Caller, go ahead.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey.
How you doing, Felicia?
Oh, is this another cleanup man? I'm doing pretty well.
Of course it is. I'm doing good.
Okay, so you another cleanup man?
Oh, of course. And so, I clean them up all day.
Oh, wow. And so what do they call you? We got the doctor in the house. Who are you?
Oh, this is KO. No, I knocked him out the box.
This is who?
He's KO. He knocks him out the box.
Oh, we got a knockout and we got a doctor.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so, you know, what are some of the reasons that you have to actually help clean up somebody else's house?
Oh, you know, I'm not even the one that's going looking. You know, they seem to find me.
And how was that?
Oh, you know, just being myself, you know, the gentleman that I am. You know, they see the gentleman that leaves it. All they got to do is see me, hear me, and it's over.
Okay, so let me ask you something. I got, okay, we got the doctor here. Doctor, what age range do you deal with?
It's really not a preference.
Okay, and KO, what age yes. range do you deal with?
Oh, you know, I'm still 28, but I'm going from 25 to 40.
You going from 25 to 40?
I'm going 25 to 40.
Okay, so what if a 21-year-old or 19-year-old came up to you?
Well, shit, 19, 20-year-olds, they still may look like they're about 28 nowadays, so you never know until you ask.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Okay, well, I want to hear, okay, I want to, doctor, let me know. Tell me something about one of your experiences.
Okay, well, one of my basic experiences is I had a wife. Well, it was a married woman or whatever else, and things weren't going right at home. She wasn't being treated right or things of that nature. So at that point, you get into their mind. You see what's going on. You communicate with them.
Okay,
you comfort them.
You said you had what? You had what?
You comfort them.
You comfort them.
As far as one of my situations, she wasn't being taken care of at home. She wasn't treated right. The husband was treating her wrong, treating her bad, and things of that nature. So she wasn't feeling good. So at that point, you know, you find out what's really going on with her, and then you play on that part.
Okay.
We have a call. You guys can call back. Okay. So basically, what you're saying is that there's a problem at home. They're not being treated right. I mean, okay. So I get not being treated right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay. So, but does that call for you to run out and? Okay, we're going to take that call.
Let's take the call.
But does that mean you run out and start finding somebody else because you feel like you're not treating right? Communication is key.
Well, sometimes it's not even about running out and things like that. It's about communicating and talking to somebody and talking about the issues that you have at hand. And then it ends up going into something else. It escalates into something else.
Okay, caller, you have a question?
Caller. Yes, I'm back.
Okay, we're going to put you on hold for a minute. Okay.
Okay.
All right. So it's about them missing something. So you as a cleanup man, see, I'm going to get down to the nitty gritty. All that we know they missing something if they out there messing with you. So what is your situation? You just out there, you can tell, you can see? Because we're talking about married women. We're talking about women that are actually in relationships. How does this occur?
Okay, basically it could strike anywhere. It could strike with a coworker. It could strike at work. It could strike in the market or wherever you entertain the conversation at. And you start communicating with a person, and you start having phone conversations, different things like that, and they start feeling needed.
Okay.
We got another call. Caller. Go ahead, caller.
Can I speak now?
Sure.
Yeah, go ahead. Who's calling?
I'm speaking. Okay. I have a question. So when you meet these women, do you tell them that you're not interested in commitment or anything, or do they just... you're on the radio show now, so all these women, do they know that you're the cleanup man, or do you just kind of play them?
First and foremost, it's not playing, but fact of the matter is they know what they're stepping into when they step into it. They're the ones who marry. So if they marry, they know what they're doing. They're the one who's stepping out. They need a prescription. Give them what they need.
Oh, okay. I was just wondering if you know, that conversation never comes up.
Well, we could talk about anything, but once you get the prescription, you're going to want to come back anyway.
Okay. Okay. I just was wondering if you're honest with them.
Well, I might lie to kick it.
One thing about it,
sweetheart, I'm addicted to feeling good, so if she's making me feel good, you know what I'm saying? If I got to lie to kick it, then that's what I'm going to do. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to tell her what she want to hear.
Oh, okay. It's like that. Yeah. Okay. Okay.
Like I just said, if you would listen, I told you before, I don't play with feelings or emotions. I just play.
Okay. That, I guess I didn't hear that part.
Oh, okay.
So, but at least you're honest. That's cool. Okay.
Right. Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right.
I got one there.
He said he would lie to kick it.
I would lie to kick it. A cleanup man is a man that most of the time is somebody that has somebody in their life, that a relationship or married. So that's what I would consider being cleaning up something. If she's in a relationship. Because she's single, it's a different story. But if she with somebody, most of the time when they step out, it's something missing at home.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to help out.
I feel you.
Oh, okay.
Got another caller.
You're trying to help out, but okay. So, what if somebody does that to you? I mean, I'm still trying to understand. Okay, you a cleanup man. How do you meet a cleanup man? How do you go about meeting a cleanup man?
It could be somebody that just like you. like something about you.
Well, have you ever been a cleanup man? Because you sure explaining that.
I was a cleanup man once in my day, once in my time. Yeah, I was.
And nobody has a problem with being a cleanup man, meaning nobody has a problem with stepping on another man's territory?
Well, go ahead. Let the cleanup man talk about it. Go ahead, doctor.
Well, my prime position wasn't dealing with him. It was dealing with the wife that he wasn't dealing with. So it kind of like a domino effect. He's not dealing with her. She needs to be dealt with, so I deal with her.
Okay.
So therefore, it was a favor. Like I say, I'm not playing with feelings or emotions. And you get to know a person, things like that, and it goes from there. And it just like snowballs down. So as it snowballs down, things take effect.
Okay, we're going to take another call.
Go ahead, caller.
Yes, I guess what you would call the woman that needs to be cleaned up, or that has the cleanup man.
Mm-hmm. So you want to be cleaned up?
I don't need to be. Don't need to be cleaned up, but unfortunately, I do have a cleanup man.
Oh, okay. Wow. And what was your reason to have a cleanup man?
And I hear you guys talking about communication and all of that, but here's the thing. You can communicate to your husband all damn day, and at the end of the day, if he's not taking that communication and putting it to work, then how can you communicate to yourself?
So does that mean you have to step out and get somebody to communicate with, or is it
not necessarily communication, but who likes to feel lonely when you have somebody laying right next to you?
Right. Right. I understand that.
Right.
So if I have someone that's showing me attention, that's listening to me, that gives me the attention that I need, you don't think I'm going to jump on that?
So what about, so do you feel that if that person that you with that's on the outside and you're not getting that on the inside, why not just let that person that's not giving that to you go?
Because you're dealing with security, boo.
Exactly.
So security.
She, at the end of the day, my security is right here. Uh-oh. My feel good is out there. Mm. So to make my security feel good, I'm going to keep doing this right here.
All right. Well, alrighty then.
All right.
I want to feel good, and I'm gonna keep my security. So that sounds like a smart woman. I got my my stock over here, which I'm gonna keep. Go ahead.
So I understand the doctor. I understand him loud and clear. So he got to feel good.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Do you get tired?
I got a nurse that makes me feel good too.
Mm-hmm.
She got a nurse. What?
You got a nurse.
That
what?
Feel good.
She got a nurse that makes her feel good. A nurse?
A nurse?
Yeah, he the doctor. I got a nurse. She just heard from KO.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
Mm-mm.
Oh.
I got confused. There's
okay,
a nurse
I see. Team. No, she got a nurse.
Oh, she's a nurse?
No. She
no,
got
no,
a
nurse. No, boo-boo.
She
I got
a nurse.
Oh.
He's a doctor.
Let's
she
get
got...
this clear.
You got a nurse. So,
yeah.
Okay.
She
oh, so a nurse takes care of your cleanup.
So y'all must be listening slow.
Well, I must be listening slow. I was trying to get
I,
it right.
I got you.
Well, I bet you do. I bet you she got a nurse. So she got a Father God, she has a nurse. She don't need the doctor. And she don't need KO. She don't need KO. And she don't need the doctor. She got a nurse. Well, have at it. We got nurses in the hospital.
As long as it works for you, that's what matters.
That's what matters.
So, hey, as long as you're feeling good and you got your security, sweetheart, everything is all good.
Yes.
Oh. I agree.
Okay. All right. Thanks for calling.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Okay, this is a no holds bar conversation, right? So it didn't say it had to be a doctor. Is that KO on there? KO.
KO.
Yeah.
Okay, you hear that?
Did you hear the did he hang up?
Yeah, he go.
Okay.
He go back.
Anyway, this is amazing conversation because I mean it doesn't matter who's making you feel good. I guess it's all about whatever you want, right?
So yeah, float your boat.
Yeah, right. Nurses and we got people knocking them out, KOs, and we got doctors. Okay, so let's get back to Diggy Doc. About how many cleanups have you done? And how many cleanups do you do in about a year?
Well, we have to understand right now that this is my past of cleanup. Right now I'm happily married, so I'm not cleaning up anymore.
Okay.
But as a number of counting, things like that, I didn't count. And, you know, I handed them on individual situations. And I had one where it was a situation. It was to the point where, you know what I'm saying, you don't know what a, how far a woman to go. And in saying that, I used to drive her husband's car.
Now, see, you know, that's doing a whole lot.
Well,
see,
I don't play with feelings or emotions.
You don't play with feelings or emotion, but that's playing with life. I mean, for a woman to even step that far, she have to be lost in
she
space.
She got to be lost in space,
Well, you know, I mean, that's when you get the prescription. You're kind of numb to it
but
all.
But that prescription is she's looking for to be, that's hers, it. Like, I don't think she's looking for.
It's different from keeping it over here and then bringing it home, and you got this man's car, and that's deep.
Yeah, well, outside of that as well, they started being intimate. He was sexually frustrated. Mm-hmm. I told her to charge him.
What?
I told her to charge him.
He was sexually frustrated.
She wasn't taking care of him. She was taking care of me.
So. Okay, see, if he's sexually frustrated.
Because he ain't getting it from her.
But he could be getting it from her if she would give it to him, if she wasn't giving it to the doctor.
Yeah,
but I sent her home and told her to give him some.
Okay, you know, that's a lot of nerve for you to have a husband. You're going to deny him, give it to him, and then tell him he's frustrated.
And then
but then
why
you said
he
you wasn't getting
this.
No.
Yeah.
I'm confused.
Okay, but then at the same time, then we charged him.
We charged him.
Well, I told him it could be handled for a fee. He put the fee, he put the money on the dresser, done their thing. She met me the next day.
Gave you the money.
Yes.
That sounds like pimping.
Well, it's all in doctorism.
Doctorism. he said it's all in doctorism.
Yeah, well, you know.
Okay, so, you know.
It's not Medi-Cal, it's doctorism. You know what I'm saying? It comes with a fee.
Okay.
Her husband paid a cleanup man to clean his wife so he can get a little.
Right.
Well, I think that's dangerous.
That's really dangerous.
I think that's very dangerous. I can't imagine how a woman would step on and do something like that. I mean, I think, you know, women, we like to communicate there's a problem. We need to try to fix a problem before we try to create another problem. But that sounds like, she sounded like she was sexually frustrated for her to step outside her marriage or her relationship or whatever. She had to be the one sexually frustrated.
Yeah. Okay. And she's blaming it on him.
And then you sit up here talking about the doctor and the prescription. And I know all this is good, but at first there has to be some wooing. Women don't just drop draws because you talking about, you know, because she's frustrated. You have to, there's going to be some coffee, some dinner, there's going to be some movie, there's going to be something that has to take place because whatever she's missing at home, she's looking for you to give. So you're doing some giving more than just what you're saying. You know, you're not physically, you know, you're saying you're not emotionally tied. But I know to get it started, there has to be a little bit more time and effort put into it.
And
right?
That's correct, yes. Yeah, you put in time, you're going to put in the work to get to the situation where you're trying to get to.
But how do you get to the mindset of just being a cleaner man? Who wants to clean up behind somebody? Yeah. I wouldn't.
At that point in time in my life, that's where I was at with it. I was a woman connoisseur. So therefore, you know what I'm saying, just like you taste test wine, I taste test women.
Taste test.
That's what it is.
You look like
you know, when you're a connoisseur, you're a connoisseur. Like
you're
I say.
Are you okay?
I'm going to the doctor over here.
Well, the doctor, like I say, I'm addicted to things that make me feel good. So if she makes me feel good, then I want it. And then it's coming at a price and a cost, and it's a favor for a favor. The DOC is what I gave her, is what it is.
The DOC. Okay.
That's the doctor.
The doctor. Well, yes. Do we have any frustrated women out there that want to call in and talk to the doctor? So maybe you might not really need a prescription of how to stay away from having to see the doctor. You know.
RKO.
I'm saying preventive measures is actually really important. You know what I'm saying? You prevent you from stepping outside of yourself. I mean, nowadays it's kind of
prevent you from stepping outside.
What would prevent you from stepping outside?
As long as you got everything at home, you're good. You know what I'm saying? It's just a matter of having everything at home for you. You know what?
I was looking at one of those comments from our last show last week, and basically it was saying it was almost like it was like a death sentence to have the same cookie for life. You know what I'm saying? It was almost like, oh my God, the thought. And that's a man speaking. That wasn't a woman like man. This is the same thing for the rest of my life. So, you know, but I think what they said was the cookie should never be closed or the door should never be closed or whatever the case may be.
The cookie should always be on the counter to take a bite out of, basically. That's what they're saying.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm just trying to understand how. this, this, it's not hard for me to understand, but mm-hmm. I think that it's more to it than what the doctor is saying. I think that you, for you to go in and actually drive somebody's car, mm-hmm. and for her to give you somebody's car and let you drive, for her to even let you get in her head to say, you gonna charge him, she was looking for way more. That was a fatal attraction waiting to happen, I'm sure.
So what, let me ask you a question. Was you driving ahead. In the car with her, or you just drove by yourself?
It's been both. Been both ways. Yeah. Been both ways.
She both.
That must, but be, see, that must that, be a heavy description.
At that point in time in my life, you know, I was reckless anyway. Yeah. So no harm, no foul. It didn't matter. And like I say, I didn't know him. I wasn't worried about him. Yeah. And his feelings are his emotions. He's not treating her right.
So and you she's feel like put you in, are?
I am what? I'm giving her what she needs. I'm giving her what she's missing. So when she's with me, yeah, she's getting treated right.
So how long
she's getting
this...
the things that she's missing and needs, so that makes her feel good.
Okay. So how long does this take? How long is there a time frame on this situation, or is this continuous?
It's never a process, a certain time limit on it. You put in time, you put in work, you date, you hang out, you know, you go places, you make her feel special, make her feel wanted.
Okay, so it's not really just about the sexual gratification.
No, that's gonna fall in place.
Okay, so in essence, you're dating her.
Yes, somewhat, yeah.
Okay, but you...
Pretty much, yes. Mm-hmm.
But you're saying there's no feelings involved.
I could date you and not have no feelings for you.
Hmm. Well, it's obviously that this particular person had feelings for you because she put herself out there, way out there, as far as cars and different things like that. And a lot of times, what I would say to that is, if you're not happy, the best thing that you could do is probably leave.
Leave.
Right,
because don't want to leave that security blanket.
I'm gonna tell you, that's easier said than done, because like I say, a lot of people stick around and stay around for different reasons.
Right,
you got security reasons, you got financial reasons, you have things that you probably acquired together or whatever else that doesn't allow you to just leave. So you step out and you come find the cleanup man and get clean.
Right. He said, and get clean. Okay.
Get that prescription.
Well.
Yeah.
That's okay. So
we had more callers.
What can we do to prevent the cleanup man? Tell me what. Give suggestions on what can be done in order not to actually need the cleanup man. I think everybody at some point in time that's been in a long-standing relationship. You know what I'm saying? Things get stagnated. I understand that. You know what I'm saying? Things might not go the way they were when you first got together. You know, when you first get together, it's all fun and good, whatever, whatever. And then you get with this person and you marry this person. Then you got to share money and bills and attitudes. And things change because I just tend to believe when you first get together, you got your acting shoes on, right? You know, everything is good. But then eventually they get to see that other side of you. Eventually they're going to see the other side of you, which might not be so nice, but you guys have to have merged your lives together, you know, and then to go out and step out and then deal with somebody else is just, I think, just adds fuel to the fire. That's just my thing. But I wonder, a lot of times men can't accept the same things that they do to women, you know, so we had the side chick.
Mm-hmm.
Now we got the cleanup man, and the side chick thing was just, man, that was just a trip. I'm wondering, do we have as many side chicks. Have as many cleanup men as we have side chicks?
I'm quite sure.
You know, we just heard KO called in. He's young. He's 28 years old. You know, he's still having fun. There's probably no feelings tied to that. You're an older gentleman. You know, you had your days and you've been out there. But in your age range, what was your age range?
I didn't too much care about the younger ones or whatever else, but
because you probably couldn't hang with the young ones. The young ones was probably gonna have you on, you know, standing on top of your head.
I never said I didn't have anything young, because I could run a young one just like I could run an old one.
Okay. Here go, Funk. Go ahead, caller.
How you guys doing?
We good. How are you?
Good. I just wanted to elaborate a little bit on what our cleanup man had to say this evening.
What'd you say? Go. You know what? Can you hear us?
I hear you. Can you hear me?
Okay, go ahead.
Now. Yeah,
go ahead. Say what now?
Okay. I just wanted to say that, as he stated earlier, that people step out for all different types of reasons. And there's a cleanup man, and there's situations where you just kind of stumbled onto it that are not quite the same as what the cleanup man does. And I think that what happens is that when we're in these marriages, the first mistake we women make is sharing the problems that we have. That allows the cleanup man to recognize and see the deficits in the relationship and jump in. But I believe that in a relationship, you shouldn't be sharing information about it. But what happened in my case is, without me even realizing how unhappy I was, I met someone, and it was a friend from the past. And I probably shouldn't have had the conversation to begin with. But as I began to talk to him, and he began, and we began to talk more and more and more, I realized that he had a lot of the qualities and the things that I wasn't getting at home. And you have your women that are just career cheaters, and then you have people like myself who just happened to stumble onto something and ended up with a cleanup man in the end.
So
every woman doesn't go out looking for that.
So he said all the things you want to hear. That's what you're saying, right? And did all the things that you want to get at home.
I don't think he necessarily said everything that I wanted to hear. He just paid attention to me at a time. He didn't give me anything different than what my husband gave me. I was just not happy at home, period, and he was entertainment for me.
Okay.
Not necessarily.
I don't know that she was so wrong, but she just said she wasn't happy. And sometimes you don't even realize you're not happy. You just go day to day doing the same thing over and over. You have no idea that you're not even happy. You just keep on keeping on. And then all of a sudden, somebody looks at you different. Somebody says your hair looks good, or I like what you're wearing, because you're not getting those certain things. Because what happens is, a lot of times people, your mate takes you for granted. And you get up, you know, and you still want to know that you look good. You still want them to have that same spark they had when you actually first met them. And then the spark starts to die because they get comfortable. And when you get comfortable, you get sloppy and things can happen. So she gets outside and not even knowing that she's not happy. She's at work and the man just started talking about how pretty her hair. You know, oh, you changed your hair color. He actually, somebody noticed.
Yeah,
okay. Oh, that's a nice dress.
Mm-hmm.
And so now she's feeling like, oh, you know, I'm still pretty. You know, I still got it, because we all at the end of the day want to know we still have it. Okay, so it's important that whoever your mate is, whoever
you're
dealing with,
should pay attention to you.
And of course you should pay attention. But you guys are men. And what happens is, you stop doing all the things you did to get them, and then all of a sudden somebody else is doing the same thing that you were doing, and she realizes, you know what, I missed that. And she don't just think about it. It just happens. So I get what the caller is saying. She's just saying, I didn't even go looking for it. I got me a cleanup man, but at the same time, if homeboy at home would have been handling his business, I wouldn't need a cleanup man. Because I think men get complacent, and sometimes they don't need the same, you know, attention or whatever. But women do. We are emotional creatures, and we want to feel like we're, you know, that you still love us, and that we're still pretty to you, and we still got it, you know. And you just walking around like whatever. And so then it happens. So like she said, I didn't look for it. Connor, that was a good, you know, that was some good insight.
Yeah,
because
I never looked for it. You just go when you're at work. You make friends with people. It's never intentional. It can just happen. But again, you have those who are just career cheaters who like to do that, just like the side chick who enjoys it. And in my case, in my situation, I'm not that person, nor did I ever believe in stepping out of marriage or having a cleanup man. But it happened. And it can happen to any woman. It can happen to any man. You got to listen to your mate. You got to hear what they're saying.
And pay attention.
You got to tell them what you're not getting at home. Mm-hmm. Because one thing I could say before my marriage ended was, don't act like I ain't been telling you for years. I didn't just jump up, you know, I spoke, and we have to communicate, and what your man chooses to do with that, that's on him.
So your marriage actually did end.
It did end, not as a result of the cleanup man. The cleanup man cleaned up and went on about his way, but he helped me to realize what I did brought me a little bit of shame. And it helped me to realize that I need to leave this marriage because I'm not getting what I need here, and what I'm doing is going out doing things that I never thought I would ever do before. It happens to the best of us.
That's right.
We get weak. You know, it can happen to anyone. Everybody is just not a career cheater, but you got to communicate. And I know, I understand when you got to stay due to financial reasons or whatever, but the best thing to do, if you're not happy and he does not meet your needs, is to leave.
That's right.
Because what the cleanup man had his chick doing will get you killed. It will get you killed, and you know, and you got to have boundaries, and you have to set boundaries, and we can't, as women, that's pure disrespect to go out and to give your side man your husband's car.
Well, that's because now she's thinking her side man is her man. See, she got confused. That she was totally, had totally lost her mind and probably was ready to get home and everything.
And you will lose sight of who's who and what all the titles are. That will happen.
Look, is that right? Yes. So did you start thinking that your cleanup man was your man?
He was my first thought in the morning, my first call. If something happened, he was who I called. I gave him everything that my husband should have gotten.
Mm. Wow. Men, are you listening? Are you listening?
You better realize when she get that hair dyed and that new hairstyle.
What that mean?
That's being attentive to her, paying attention to her.
Oh, you said you better recognize it.
You better recognize it, yeah. When she walk in the house and they got their hair done.
One of the things that I learned when I became single again out there is that the game has changed. Ooh. Women have stepped up. Women have stepped up now, and they step out. They will do the same thing now that what men have been doing to us for decades.
Right. Thank you, caller. We're going to take another call. Thank you so much for the call.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Right. Bye-bye.
Go ahead, Carla.
Hello?
Go ahead.
Hey, I'm watching. I just wanted to say, I think you guys, I see the comments and I hear the callers, but I feel like you guys are tiptoeing around a lot of the issues that some of these women are just hoes.
Uh-oh.
Like, it's the saying you can't turn a hoe into a housewife. Well, some of these hoes is getting wifed up.
You said some of the hoes is getting wifed up?
Yeah, and they bring that into the relationship with them. The thing about it is because people just think that, once a woman gets older, or a person gets older, they get more mature and all that. But if you've been hoeing for 30 years, you can be 40, 50 and still be a hoe.
Okay, so what you're trying to say is the man married a hoe, so for a woman to step outside of marriage means she had to be a hoe anyway?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying you guys are asking the question, why would a woman go outside of her marriage and get the cleanup man or get the side dude or whatever? And some of it isn't even that deep as far as emotions and all that. Some of these women just want to play. They see a dude that they like, they find attractive, and it might be just purely sex. But I'm just saying, like, you can't put it past the just regular thing that some of these women are just hoes. And they come into their relationship like that, and they may be good at wearing that mask, but at the end of the day, they are who they are. So, you know what I mean? And they want that picture perfect. They want, you know, just that cookie cutter, this relationship, I got this and that. Maybe it's the image, maybe it's whatever they're going for. But, I mean, at the end of the day, you can only wear that mask so long.
So you heard that. Some of them was hoes.
You can't turn a housewife into a hoe.
A hoe into a housewife. Not a housewife to a hoe. A hoe into a housewife. But you can turn a housewife into a hoe, too.
Yeah.
So, fellas, if you're out there, you better be careful who you putting that ring on. You know what I'm saying? You could be over here, it was the past. All right.
Look, housewives is turning into hoes, and hoes is being turned into housewives. And he said, if you married a hoe and made her housewife, then that's what you get, because she back to hoeing, pretty much. That's what he said in a nutshell. Wow.
Thanks for calling.
She's going to be who she's going to be. Thank you, guys.
All right. Appreciate you, man. Thanks.
Thank you. Thanks
for
the call.
So in saying that, you could say that each individual case is different.
Different.
So you have to handle it that same way. Everybody has their own purpose and reason for stepping out.
But we stepping.
Yeah.
Stepping in the name of love. What is stepping, that?
So
what
therefore.
Is that, DJ? Step in the name of love.
But if you see in like the main root cause of it or something like that, it's something that the woman is missing at home.
These folks need a psychiatrist.
Didn't they have a song called The Cleanup Woman?
It's a cleanup woman. It's a woman's dude. We got another caller.
Go ahead, caller.
Father God, honey.
Caller, go ahead.
Who's this?
This is you're on the radio.
Okay, I'd like to speak. They ready for him?
Go ahead.
Hello?
Yeah, we here. We Turn down your laptop or your computer.
Okay, I got it.
All right.
Okay.
All right, go ahead.
Yeah, they were saying that I was just listening. This is kind of comical because, you know, back in the day, if you go, the women go to a strip club, they turn into a beast anyway. I had my boys used to do a little strip thing. I watched from the background, married and all. It looked like they got let out of cage.
Who, the man or the woman?
The women in a strip club.
Like they had got let out of a cage. So maybe they man needs to dance for them at home. What you think?
I don't know about that. But, you know, it just didn't just start. The cleanup man, he did his job. That's all.
The cleanup man did his job.
Yeah, that's what he was asked to do.
Okay,
no
so
ties.
Okay. It sounds like you're familiar with being a cleanup man because you sound like you're talking from experience. So basically what you're saying is when women get let out, it's like they're being let out from a getting let loose. You said from a cage.
Oh, basically, you know, back in the day, like my man said, back in the day, remember when the game was big, brothers had 5, 6, 7 women. You had women having babies by the same dude. And if he got locked up and went to jail, damn, somebody else got to take care of the babies. So, you know, they were looking for the next dude, the next baller.
You know what?
And they got caught up in that, too.
Okay, so you guys are not giving women enough respect to me is basically saying, okay, so women get let, we go to a strip club and the man is dancing. It's like being let out of the cage. Okay.
Oh, wow. Come on. Women paying like they weigh. Come on, man.
They paying what?
Like
they pay like they weigh.
Wow, so if you weigh 200, you're giving out 200. That's a cold piece of work. Mm. He said they paying like they weigh.
Like they weigh.
But what's wrong with just having fun? Everything is not about laying down with somebody. Everything is not about the cleanup man, though, right?
But you know, about brothers going to strip club. When women go to strip club, they pull out money.
And
what they paying
too.
For?
And what,
they paying
what,
for entertainment, enjoyment, the same thing.
Exactly, and men do the same thing. So the whole thing is, why does a woman need a cleanup man? Why would she need somebody to come and clean up behind her mess? Behind her man's mess?
Behind her man's mess? Sometimes it ain't her man's mess.
Why would, okay, I'm speaking as a woman. How would, a woman steps out for what reason? She's not getting what she wants at home or what she thinks she's supposed to have at home? Doesn't mean she's the man married a hoe and turned her into a wife. It doesn't mean any of that. Like the caller before you all said, some shit just happens. It's just basically what happens is you didn't even realize you wasn't happy because everybody got so complacent in the relationship. And all of a sudden somebody's paid you some attention. And then now it's like you feeling some kind of way. You feel different. You feel pretty. What I'm saying is a lot of times in the relationships, you got to make sure you take care of your man as well as, you know, man takes care of his woman. You know, it's important to keep that going on because there's a lot of people out here. It's going to always be somebody prettier, always be somebody skinnier. It's going to always be that, but it's still not going to be you. And so if it's worth being in a relationship, whether it's for whatever it is, I think you owe each other enough respect to be able to handle, take care of your side. That's just how I feel. Y'all talking about strippers and all this other stuff. You know, these women that are stepping out feel like they got a reason. They're lonely and got a man laying next to them. And that's a sad state of affairs. When you got a man laying next to you and you still lonely. And I think that's basically what it is. These women are lonely and they're trying to find love in a different place. Now, some of them might go into it with their mind thinking that, you know, no strings attached. But 9 times out of 10, women get attached.
Well, you have to look at it. Women play with feelings and emotions.
Of course we do.
Okay, and
thanks, caller.
The basic thing is what it is the man at home is not handling his business. He's not doing what he's supposed to be doing.
So do you agree with that,
caller? To keep her proper and make her feel the way she needs to feel. So then you have a person go out, and like I say, it could happen at work, it could happen to Mark, and then once you open up conversation, a woman start talking. Then you listen to the conversation, you listen to the things that she's not getting, and you give her the things that she's missing. And she's hungry for that. She's temporarily insane.
Oh.
that's a prescription, doctor.
He said she's temporarily insane.
Yeah.
So
and basically she is through the whole ordeal of what's taking place. She's temporarily insane. She's not herself.
That's good.
She's not herself.
Doctor,
she's taken out of her character.
I believe that.
and she needs something. It's just like a headache. If you have a headache, you take a pill.
Are you drinking some water? You know, that's good.
You have to take something for something.
Temporary insanity.
Temporary insanity, and she is. So therefore, that's why the man has to do what he has to do to take care of home.
But
and give her what she needs, and she's gonna cure that headache, and she's gonna come get the pill.
You a married man, and from your experience as being a cleaner man, now you a married man. How are you with taking care of your home? Because well, you know there can be a cleaner man come behind you.
Yeah, well, if I have to sit and worry about that, then you know I'll be temporarily insane too.
So he don't worry
about that. I'm not dead. I don't have no worries with that. I try to do the best that I could do as a husband nowadays.
But I'm saying you should be actually like a expert because you was the doctor. Now you got a wife, so you understand. I mean, tell me, are there signs for when a woman starts to change? Are there signs?
It could happen anywhere. You're going to see different changes. She might dress different. She might do different things different. She might stay at the grocery store too long.
She might be wearing matching panties and bras now, right?
Yeah,
you know,
right.
Before she had all
she might not be wearing granny panties no more.
I mean, you have to look around.
She might just wear granny pants around him, but then she go around the cleaner man and she wear that sexy stuff.
Well, if he don't care about the
granny. If she accidentally come over with the sexy things on, you going to ask what the heck?
You talking about some granny panties.
She got granny panties on.
Yeah, when your butt get wide, you get some granny panties too. When you get cold.
Nah, I know some wide busters don't wear no granny panties. you see all day long, they don't wear no granny panties.
Look at this.
But see, the root cause of it is the man has to do what he's supposed to do.
Got to do what he got to do.
That's the main thing. Don't allow for somebody else to step in. Don't allow the cleanup man to come clean your mess up.
Don't take for granted for what you got at home.
Don't take for granted for what you got at home.
But
keep,
we do.
Keep your
but
relationship
you do. But you do.
Active. Keep it alive.
Well, does that tell me this? Since you guys talking, I got the doctor over here, you know, that you doctize people, and then I got this one over here that had his little situations too, no more granny panties and all of that. So my thing is, how is she supposed to keep the attention of her man?
It's the same thing as you said. Men get complacent when they with a woman. They do this, they do that, they do this, and once they get comfortable, they don't do it no more.
Mm-hmm.
Vice versa. Just flip the script.
Flip the script, as Evan, you say, doctor.
Basically, when you're in a relationship, or when you're in a marriage or whatever else, you have to keep the fire burning.
Keep the fire burning.
You have to keep the fire burning. Stay active. Do something different. If you're hitting her this way, turn around, hit her that way the next time or something. You know, just keeping it real as a doctor. You know, keep it exciting.
And always be observant to her. You know what I'm saying? Whatever it is.
So, again, are you guys listening to this, ladies? It's the man's responsibility. He is the head of the house. He is the one that's supposed to be leading his family. Right? Is that what y'all saying, right?
Yeah. So, and the main thing, you have to listen to your wife.
You got to listen.
You have to listen. And you can't just let things go through one ear and out of every. You have to make a difference. You have to make a difference in the situation as to what she's saying to you. You have to feed into it. If you feed into her, she's going to feed back into you.
Okay. I believe
you
that.
You know what I'm saying? So if you're not feeding her, she's hungry. She need to eat.
It's not like a dog.
she going to go get something to eat. You know what I'm saying? It's all what it is.
Oh my goodness.
It's just keeping it real and just making it plain on what it is. So to the men out there, you have to listen to your wife and do what you need to do.
So this be your wife, your girlfriend, whatever, your mate.
Any type of relationship. It could be woman on woman or whatever else. Listen to your mate.
Whatever you started
and
doing
it goes
in
both ways.
Whatever you started doing in that relationship, don't stop doing it. Whatever it took you to get her, you don't stop doing that.
It's
you add
so
to it.
It's so easy for us to sit up here
I'm
just saying it's
I'm
so
saying,
easy for us to have these conversations, Eddie.
But you're saying...
You didn't let me finish saying what I was saying. What I was saying was it's so easy for us to sit up here and have these conversations and for men to say what's supposed to be done, but how many people actually put in the effort? We can say what needs to be done,
but who
actually puts in the effort? Because what happens is, as time goes by, you think you're still doing the same thing you was doing when you got your wife?
No, you just try to do better.
I'm in a different.
I'm
doing things differently now than I used to do before.
Okay,
so I think I'm a better individual now, and I respect women. And the things that I was doing in me as a cleanup man, it wasn't respectful to women. I was born by a woman. I was raised around women, but the things that I was doing, I didn't have any feeling or emotions about what I was doing.
Think that's a generational thing?
I don't look at it like that. I think it was a doctor's thing. That's all I know. It was just me, the DOC. I'm only responsible for myself. I can't say if it came from generations. My mother told me to be the best at what I do, and I was the best doctor out there.
Wow.
With the prescription.
The cleanup man. the doctor. If you need a prescription, he was there to service you. He said, what was that he said, Ed? He said you were temporarily insane.
Temporarily insane.
Have you ever heard of temporarily insane?
I just heard tonight.
But then right. You also had the caller. What'd she say? She said he was the first thing that she thought about when she woke up.
And when she
was the first thing she thought about when she went to sleep. Mm-hmm. He stayed on her mind. So then she got emotionally tied. Mm-hmm. That sounds like some emotional ties.
Yes. Yeah.
You know, man, this is fantastic that we can get a little clarification from all these men we have sitting around here, you know. So what would you say, Eddie, would be the one thing that you would tell a girlfriend, a wife, or whatever that was having some issues with her husband or her boyfriend and she felt like she wasn't getting the attention she need? What should she tell him or say to him? What conversation should she have in order to try to turn those things around?
Sit down and let him know what it is that she needs.
Okay. And so if he's not a good communicator, then what? Just go and call the cleanup man? Because you out of business.
He out of business. You got to call K.O.
You got to call K.O.
K.O. Right. K.O. handle him for
K.O.
you.
K.O. handle
him. I'm good.
He's young, so
I'm
he's still good. In it.
So your thing is just tell him. Are you a listening kind of person?
Yeah, I listen.
Okay, what would be your advice?
Same thing. The main thing of it is communication. You have to communicate and you have to listen.
It's funny that you guys say this because I think women are very good communicators. I think we're very good at communicating, but what I don't think is I think men have a hard time listening.
There it is, right there.
I think it's just, you know, they just, you know, they pay attention, but they don't pay attention. And one thing about it is, somebody was telling me about love languages. Everybody's love language is different, you know. And you do things in languages, meaning, you know, if you're constantly touching somebody or whatever, that might be my love language. You know what I'm mm-hmm. saying? Or a hug or something is your constant love language. I'm showing what you need. You know what I'm saying? But what is a man's love language? What is your love language?
Basically, it's probably like touching, communication.
Okay, so you like mm-hmm. to talk? Because a lot of men don't like to talk. They really don't.
Talk, but then if the conversation kind of gets sideways or something like that, I'm quick to shut you down.
Okay.
That's so kind of like how I am.
What would be your love language, Eddie? You don't know?
No.
What are you, 55 and you don't know? you don't know what your love language is?
My love language is?
What is your love language is how you express love other than, this is what I'm saying.
I express love, the way I express love is just doing the things that I know that makes her happy.
Okay.
And whatever it is that makes her happy, that's what I do.
Okay,
you know what I'm saying? And the thing that it is sometimes you can do the things that a woman wants, but does she always do the things that you want? You know what I'm saying? And far as like,
you're saying
communication-wise, sometimes it's like a man can communicate to a woman and it can go in one ear and come out the other. Like, say, for instance, which one of these look the best, this one or this one? And you said, that looks best. Okay, throw that on the side and she gets this one. So that right there is showing you that it's not for you.
Well, what that meant is she shouldn't even ask you, because if she was going to pick what she thought was the best anyway, then what was the point in asking?
That's what I'm saying. So you got those kind of situations, too, where, you know, you don't, it don't make no, whatever you say don't matter. It's
when you're in long relationships like this, you know, I'm listening to what you guys say, mm-hmm. and everybody's saying, we're talking about love languages, and you're talking about, okay, so the person that you with, do you wake up every morning, is your wife the first thing that you think about?
Yes.
Would your mate be the mm-hmm. first thing that you think about?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
At this point in time where I'm at in my life now, I appreciate my wife. And I let her know that and things like that, so it's different now.
You appreciate your wife. So does she keep the fire? Does she keep that heat in there? She does that.
I'm in love with my wife.
That's why he's not clean. He retired.
I'm in love with my wife, and like I say, I let her know every day that how much I appreciate her.
But you had to but you've gone through a journey.
Yeah.
You've gone through some trials and tribulations, but now you've learned
to appreciate. She's with the cleanup man.
So is your wife a result of you being the cleanup man?
Was she a result of me being cleanup man?
Was she the result? What I'm saying, the results, meaning that was she somebody you was cleaning house for and end up being your wife?
the side chick. I'm not the side chick no more. Right. I am the chick.
Right. Is that what?
No, it wasn't like that. But what I will tell you though, I was in a car with another female who was. I was in a race. I don't know what I was doing. And my wife walked by and I seen her. I said, hold on, I'll be right back. And it was at a hospital or something. I went to pick up some keys. My wife's mother was in the hospital. Mm-hmm. And I was in the car. Homegirl, I was with, she was cool. Well, then I seen her walk by, and I told her, stay right here, I'll be right back. My wife went into the hospital, and she went to the flower shop.
So you were still in cleanup man mode at that time?
Yeah. Okay, I was cleaning up for real then. So I knew she went to the flower shop, so I knew she was going to go upstairs, so I went and posted by the elevator. When she came by, the cleanup man said, come here, you look a little dirty. Let me clean you up a little bit.
Now, do you mind telling the audience about that you and your wife been married twice?
Yeah, I married my wife twice.
Okay, people, this is real talk. This is why I brought him here, because this ain't no joke. This is not like he was just out there to being a cleaning man. He been out there, he been ratchet, he been all of that. But this man has married his same wife twice. And how long you guys been married? Like, total.
Oh, man, don't like put 25, 30 years? Okay, yeah, ask me no dates. And
I'm not asking no dates, but I'm saying y'all been married about twice, like a full 30 years.
Yeah, and reason being, I married my wife at an earlier stage of my life, and I was still the cleanup man. I wasn't finished cleaning. You know what I'm saying? I still had my janitor khaki suit on with my keys hanging on the side, and it was the keys to my patients' cars and stuff. So
wow.
From there, then I didn't feel the need to be married. I divorced her, and then I went. You know, then my cleaning business even expanded even more.
Yeah, that is clean business.
So at that time, but then after
mobile cleanup business, do you have a truck that sits to clean up?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So basically, after that, there and being out there and being a connoisseur and taste testing and all like that, it kind of got old and got tired. And
I can imagine.
And I was chasing a void, and what was missing was my wife.
Okay.
And I put my marriage back together. We remarried, and I've been happily married ever since.
Well, praise God. You know what?
And the truck is on that lot being sold right now.
The truck is sold
already.
No, that's the trophy.
That's the trophy. He got that sitting on top of the house like the shots.
You know. Still right there saying cleanup, man.
Well, okay, good, so that's good that you guys have history. You married your wife twice. You've been married a total of almost 30 years.
Yeah.
You married, divorced, got back together. So obviously this was meant to be. And now you have some perspective on what it really takes to make sure you keep your wife happy as well. And that's good. Is my mic on?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And see, one thing about it, you could be self-taught. I taught myself through being a cleanup man of how to take care of my wife and to make things better.
Okay, so now your idea is to make sure, because you were a cleanup man, you know that a clean man can actually come in on you as well, okay, because it ain't like you getting no younger, you know, and what they say about older women, they get them young bucks, you know, so you know what it takes in order to keep your wife where she needs to be and keep her happy. So I'm hoping that that's what you practice to make sure she's
straight. Well, the cleanup man could strike anywhere at any time in any household. Mm-hmm. Okay, and I'm aware of that, so therefore that's why I do what I do, to keep the cleanup man away.
Okay, you keep the cleanup man away.
That's a good one.
you make sure you're gonna keep the cleanup man away. No man wants no other man coming in cleaning up his home.
That's why you gotta do what you gotta do.
And basically what I learned from an old man. An older man just told me, you know, to keep your wife happy, just say yes, honey. Just say yes, honey.
Wow.
Agree, yes, honey. And like I say, keep your marriage exciting. Keep the fire burning. Do different things. And it's not all about just doing sexual things. It's about going out, going places.
Right.
And feeding into your woman.
Right.
If you feed into your woman, she's going to feed back into you.
That's true.
That's right.
And you don't have to worry about the cleanup man.
That's good knowledge. You know what? That's good knowledge. We thank you for coming. This has been truly interesting. I mean, you know what? Yeah. We have to have insight. I appreciate the callers calling in. We got people have different reasons for whatever they go through. Okay? You got a lot of experience here. You done been up and down. So now you find that your wife is the most important thing to you. And that, you know, you got to keep everything exciting, and as well as women do the same thing, you know, not get complacent in your relationships. Let's make sure we show our love language, and let's make sure we know what our love language is. And sometimes you don't even know what your love language is. Mine is touchy. I'm touchy. I'm huggy. I'm play. I want to play, grab, touch, you know, mess with your roles, mess with my roles, whatever. That's my love. It is. It's my love language. That's my love language, you know, and everybody's love language is different. Yeah. But, you know, that's what makes me happy, you know. And so you want to show that you care about your person. Whatever relationship you're in, it's about showing love and respect and caring. Because at the end of the day, I mean, this world is crazy. We got people being shot up. There's so many different things going on, right. You know. Wakanda, you know, let me say that. See my dots. But anyway, it's like by even seeing that picture, it gave us a newfound strength. I'm serious.
Yeah, that's
so good. The thing about it is, let's show our love language. Let's tell our people, our relationship, whoever that we love them, because it's important. We never know if we're going to see them when they step outside the door.
That's correct,
we don't know what this world has to offer us. So we have to be conscious and make sure that we do show our love language, because it's important. You know, we thank you, Doctor, for coming to our show. This has been truly eye-opening and enlightening for us.
And educational,
and
too.
It is educational. I also want to give a shout-out. We want to say, we want to do a little silent, just like 2 minutes, like bow our heads and close our eyes. Kevin Burrell was a police officer in Compton, California, and I believe this is the anniversary that, and I might be wrong, but this is an anniversary of him being shot. And we just want to do a little five second, close our eyes and thank God and praise him for letting us remember Kevin Burrell. Kevin Burrell, you are in our prayers. We know that you're in heaven. We just want to say, we want to give a shout out to you. Your boy Tim Watson wants to give a shout out to you, and Gary Davis wants to give a shout out to you. So I made sure that I was going to say this today, that we love you, Kevin, and thank you for watching over the city of Compton and doing the things that you did when you were a police officer for Compton. We appreciate you. We pay homage to you today, as well as we paid homage to Dolores Zarita. And we thank you guys for tuning in to our station once again. This is the Compton Exchange Talk Radio, and this is Mr. Eddie Up. Okay, he's been a cleanup man, but he's no longer in the cleaning business. I got the doc sitting next to me. He's no longer in the cleanup business, but we are in the love business, and we want to say thank you for all that you do. And tune in for us again next Thursday at 6:30 to 8. And guess what? We will be streaming live at the Grocery Outlet on Saturday. You get to come out and talk to me and Mr. Eddie Up. And guess what? We are taking sponsors. Anything that we can do to help your business, we will have somebody do a voiceovers for us. It won't be us reading these things anymore. We're trying to step our game up every Thursday. We try to get a little bit better. And we have our crew here that's helped us with the phone. So we got the phone working. We got the music working. So we're doing a whole lot better. Thank you for tuning in. Our last segment got 1,100 hits. Keep on hitting us, you guys. We got a YouTube channel. Share, help us get out there. Our desire is to actually have a real station in the city of Compton. We want to bring to you the Compton Exchange Talk Radio. And we want to be actually located in Compton. We want to represent our cities. Straight out of Compton. We talk to you soon.
All right, you guys. Check out. Me out. Thank you.
The Exchange Talk Back Radio Show. Join in on informational.
You did good, man.
What you thought, man?
Let's get your picture. Thank you.